Hosea chapter 1 verse 11. This is concerning the future blessing and restoration of Israel. Then shall the children of Judah and the children of Israel be gathered together and appoint themselves one head. And they shall come up out of the land, for great shall be the day of Jezreel. So the children of Judah and the children of Israel shall be gathered together and appoint themselves one head. Amhara. Hebraic for people, in the sense of being gathered together, and oftentimes signifying Israel, the people of Jah Almighty. Ha, Hebraic for the, and in this case, because of the people of Jah, the, there has to be an automatic of the included within Ha. So the people of the Almighty, of the head, of them that have appointed themselves one ras, one rosh, one leader. So Amhara, the people of the head to revere, of the head to reverence, to be reverenced, set themselves one head. And I rast eferi. Now this is, we're only playing around with the word Amharas, you know, when Dem Yadon put that out there, and so we just thought it'd be fun. So officially, the word Amhara is not defined as we are doing so this very instance, but you know, technically and very practically, it is well applicable to Aindai as Rast Eferi. So now Am is, you know, defined in the Hebrew as people being called together. But specifically, oftentimes, more oftentimes than not, referred to as the people of the Almighty. So now, but even we decided to play around with this a little further, and so the root word to Am is Aman, from defined as to gather together, to collect, to join. Well, actually, before we go forward, it's interesting to note that this is in a sense how we come to the word Hebrew. Be Amareña in Amharic, we have chibre, which would be union, an alliance, and you know, definitions of that sort, and even society, coming from machibre, the Ibrahist, you know, the fellowship, the union, the alliance, the confederacy, so on and so forth. Which is obviously tied into this, but we actually wanted to point out that somewhere along the line, the Anglo-Saxon individuals get their word saman. They change this word from aman to saman, and it's kind of like just to give an example of today's application in the United States would be like saman. We sound it out to be something like summon, you know, summoned to court, called, you know, collected. So just to give an example of today's application, you know, coming from the Hebrew root of Aman, but even more interestingly, well, actually, before we go forward, we get here, let's see, okay, to accumulate, kind of, that would actually apply to the multiplication, ever growing, ever strengthening, and then it gives us, Blue Letter Bible Dictionary gives us this you know, definition or this reference, and it says, and retaining the guttural. It goes on to say kinsman, father-in-law amongst the latter, but guttural. And so we thought that was interesting, so we go forward and we actually used the Merriam-Webster's dictionary and thesaurus or something like that, but okay, so we look up the word guttural, but first we come in contact with the word gut, with gut, and so the internal organs of the body. So Aindai as Rast Eferi, those the machiber, the society whom have appointed themselves one Rosh, one Ras, one head. And actually, okay, even the union, the confederacy of the children of Israel and the children of Judah. So are we not the internal organs of the body of Gitach in Jesus Christos? Yes. So it just made a lot of sense. And then it went on to say, defining gut, Merriam's Webster's dictionary, to say bowels, entrails. And so we continued on forward, and we actually came across the word guttural, and this is what it means. This is how it's defined. It's an adjective sounded in the throat, being or marked by an utterance that is strange. So marked, crossed, you know, like chosen by an utterance, by a speech that has never been seen or never been heard before, by a strange external speech. And you know, we take everything for granted, so we actually had to kind of figure out what strange meant. And according to the Merriam-Webster's dictionary, strange is only signifying external, extra, outside, not before known, heard, or seen, as is the teachings, the utterances of His Imperial Majesty, you know. And that is all tied along with this word Aman, which second definition, according to the Blue Letters Bible Dictionary Online, to shut, to close, hence to hide, to conceal, to be hidden. And so it becomes pretty obvious that we're talking about the Amen, the Aman, the hidden ones, the chosen ones, but the true and faithful, those that make up the organs, the internal organs of the body, whom have anointed themselves one head, one Ras, one leader, one example, one Jesus Christos, whom also shares part in the higher head, which would be the head of the Almighty, God being the head of Christ, Christ being the head of man, and so on and so forth. So the hidden ones, but what's it called? Those that have received, that have been marked by these utterances never before seen, heard, and so on and so forth, that can bear true and faithful witness, the elect. So the Amharas. So yeah, that's basically what I wished to share with all the I them. So you know, give thanks. Shalom, Rast Everett.